each game. He was 9 for 17.
Yeah, late, but often. A home run by Tuffel, incidentally, the Mets' 30th of the year. And this is, of course, their 22nd game. They've also hit 11 in the last 9 games. Well, the center field. Davis going back, looking up. Home run, Keith Hernandez. Tuffel and Hernandez with back-to-back home runs, and the Mets lead 4-0.
Hernandez just on fire. That low five with Darryl
Strawberry to the third baseman Chris Sabol. Fly very deep. The left fielder Daniels in left center field.
Darryl hits it a ton. Fair or foul? Home run. 3 home runs in a row. Oh. Another monster shot off the bat of Darryl Strawberry. And the Mets now lead 5-0. It hit the facade in the upper deck. There's only one player that I know of that has hit one in the upper deck here. I'm sure there have been others, but offhand, one player, George Foster, hit a 3-2 slider off Steve Carlton.
Was in Kansas City.
Will Mattingly goes deep. The Yankees are going to be in front. It's homer number 2 for Donnie this season. Single
falls bad, but his out pitch is that hard late breaking slider which you just saw. Somehow Winfield got a little piece of it to stay alive.
Here's a ball rocketed to left. Ray turns, but it's over his head and gone. Fastball down and in. The Yankees, especially this year, nothing has spoken more eloquently than Dave Winfield.
He is. Chico Walker moved over to right center field a little bit, make that left center field.
Who's on a $100 bill? I wouldn't know.
I wouldn't either.
Who's on a $100 bill? Anyway, he said, that guy's got more pictures.
Whoa, that's gone. Holy cow. Look at this one. Oh, out in the monument. Holy cow.
Oh, you go regardless, and McReynolds did that.
Excellent point. Well hit deep to left center. Back is Mac playing too low. for Gary Carter, his first since April 26th, and the Mets lead 7-4.
Career number 299 for Gary Carter, who is now one away from 300.
Looks like Jack was looking for something else there. He kind of pitched in another location.
Pretty good breaking ball, but it was right down the middle.
Hanging, and it's gone. That's gone. We don't have to worry about that one. The Yankees lead 2-0. And Storm Davis calls Jack Paul the breaking ball.
Finally hung him one. He hit it hard. Again, too.
Since 1984. As if 305 and 27 RBIs after 42 games isn't enough. Right now he's projected for more than 100 RBIs. One-oneer.
Fly ball deep right center field, moving back on it. Chili Davis, warning track, looking up, it comes.
Listen to the Yankee fans here, 3,000 miles away from home. Don Mattingly with his fourth home run of the year. Ricky Henderson aboard, and the Yankees are out front of the California Angels by the score of 4-0. And Kirk McCaskill, who has not been bitten by the home run ball. Two men out, nobody on. Fly ball deep left center field. This is way back. Going, going. It is gone. Back-to-back home runs for Mattingly and Jack Clark, who has just struck his ninth. And it is 5-0.
Home run number 9 for Jack Clark on a nothing breaking ball. A lot of high fives in the Yankee dugout. As last one, the pitching coach on the way to the...
He's ready. 1-0.
Fly ball deep left field. Way back. Could be going, going. It is good. Joel Skinner with a home run, his first of 1988. Joel Skinner does have power when he makes contact. He was 3 for his last 24 at bat before that home run.
With somebody who made a very nice living in this ballpark with a wind-up like that, Dean Chance.
He was nasty. Dean Chance had one of the hardest sliders I think I ever faced.
Yeah! Hit deep to left field. This one is gone if it stays fair. Home run, Dave Winfield. Holy cow, I tell you, that Dave Winfield, he just rocketed one down the left field line. It was gone. So Dave Winfield breaks this tie ball game up with his 10th home run on the year, 41st RBIs, and the Yankees lead 3-2.
Winfield trying to make amends for looking bad.
Batting practice in Seattle. It's just one of those things that happens. Not a whole lot you can do about it.
High fly ball in deep to left field. Goodbye. Jay
Buehner has tied this ball game up with a mammoth home run to left field. Buehner's first home run for the New York Yankees in 1988.
He had a couple of good pitches in that sequence to hit. He gets a 3-2 fastball right there from Curt Young, and I mean, he puts a hammer down way back about two-thirds of the way up
and score. Two apiece now here in the top of the sixth inning. High fly ball and deep to left field. Going back is Javier on the warning track. Goodbye. Back-to-back home runs by Buehner and Jack Clark. Clark's number 10 on the year. They put the Yankees out in front 3-2.
He had Clark out in front on that, and all the big man did was just put the bat on the ball, knocking in his 30th run on his 10th homer.
Of the original four, Lee Wire is at first, John McSherry is behind the plate, Fred Brocklander at third, and substituting at second base is umpire Larry Puncino. The regularly scheduled umpire Ed Montague could not work last night's doubleheader. He had to go to San Francisco, unfortunately, for the death of his father, and all of us send our deepest sympathies to the Montague family.
High drive in the left field, back goes Marlin to the track. To the wall, it's gone.
35 RBIs and 0-for-2 today, grounded out, lined out, and walked. And he drives one into left center and deep. Back goes Marlin. Way back, it is gone. So Jack McKeon sees another home run ball jump up and grab him. And Kirk Gibson hits his 13th, 7 of them here at Dodger Stadium, the other 6 on the road. And the Dodgers lead.
Called. So Jim Palmer had an interesting theory. Some say the lively ball last year, this year, deader baseball, why there are less home runs. Palmer simply thinks one of the components is the larger strike zone.
Whoa.
Boy, he hit this one hard, and it is going to be out of here.
And that's into a pretty stiff wind just picking up right off the corner of that upper deck coming off Lake Erie. So perhaps Allinson would have liked to have had that three ball pitch called a ball and put him on. Then you start worrying about Tolleson and Meacham instead of Winfield. So a call that went against Winfield, it appeared from our replay, looked like it should have been ball 4.
Away from picking up his second complete game in the major league.
And it will be his third victory. He's pitched a masterpiece against the Mets. Two men down, the batter Howard Johnson. Fans draw in on the grass, and Howard Johnson, it's a fly ball, a deep right field. Dawson going back, he's going back. It's now 6-3. Home run, Howard Johnson. Howard Johnson turning the wind around here at Wrigley Field.
And that is the first home run given up by Jeff Pico in his major league career. Howard Johnson getting his third against the Cubs. He leads all the Mets hitters in home runs against the Cubs, and that's his 12th home run of the year.
And his 33rd RBI. Vance Law going in to talk to
Cumbers. 21 and 33, and now number 6, because when Billy Martin was ushered out, along with him went Art Fowler and Cleet Boyer. So he picked up Boyer's uniform.
High drive into dead center. Back goes Gallagher at the wall, at the fence, gone. Home run, Clark. Oh, did he rip it?
That's about a 420-foot shot over the center field wall.
Talking to him before the ball game, Clark was talking about how I just don't like to give up that fastball if it's from the middle of the plate in. And I tell you, he really drilled that one straight away. And when you talk about
the freeways which go by the stadium, the Ohio River, the bridges into Kentucky, and underneath the blimp, downtown Cincinnati. There's a drive in the right field. It's back Strawberry all the way back, and it's out of his glove and over the wall for a home run. Terry Steinbach, the all-star, who a lot of people said should not be here, hits a home run. Doesn't it figure?
Well, number six on the year, something that does not happen very often off Doc Gooden. He doesn't really catch up, but he likes the ball away, as you see the jubilation. 16 last year, 6 this year, but he did.
The difficulties with the transmission of the telecast there. Here we're in the last of the eighth inning. One out, Rick Cerrone at first, and Steve Farr just into the game to face Dwight Evans, who's up in that front toe. Drive toward left, toward the wall, way back, and tied up! Sox started the game with Dwight Evans on the bench and trailing 6-0 by the fifth inning. And now in the eighth inning, they have come back to tie the game. Boston on its feet still at Fenway Park. They want Dwight Evans to take a bow.
Again, hitting cleanup now in the absence of Greenwell, who, after singling home a run in the sixth, was taken out of the game because of a bad right ankle. Here's the pitch. Long drive!
The 27-year-old Kevin Romine, only in the game because of the injury to the All-Star Greenwell, today's hero. The home run in the ninth inning is the first that he has ever hit in the big leagues. And what a moment for Romine, an inning after the veteran Dwight Evans homered to tie it against Steve Farr. Romine hits his first home run, and what a spot for it, and what a moment. And Boston, after trailing 6-0, has come all the way back and won this ball game.
And Larry Parrish there just in time to congratulate Kevin Romine. You think he'll remember that one for a while? Well, Steve Farr curveballs his out pitch. He hung it up in Kevin Romine's eyes. Boy, Joe Morgan has things going in the right direction early on in his first three games as manager of the Red Sox. 3 in a row.
And Farr, who had given up only 2 home runs all year, gives up 2.
The voice of Bob Shepard over the PA system in the background. Been here since 1951 as the in-house voice of the Yankees.
I thought that was John Miller. Orioles broadcasters are great. Bob Shepard. Slot, that's with the timeout coming down behind second base down from the left center field bullpen. And they pinch it for Skinner. Stott will come on.